Kelsey and the others were true to their word. By summer's end, they'd gathered what belongings they could and arranged a caravan for transport. In spite of myself, I felt my heart sink as I watched them go. Friends, family, fading away into the world beyond the bridge. And who could fault them? Graham and I met that first winter with purpose. With little else to distract us, we stockpiled food, blankets, firewood, crates full of midnight milk. We laid fresh thatching and boarded up windows till our muscles ached. Wouldn't be enough, of course. Perhaps part of me knew it at the time. But I was hopeful, awaiting a spring that would never come. The Sleepy Dragon, in a charming new location. Not only was the cabin on the cliff cozier and easier to warm, it was nearer the frozen woods and the hunting traps I'd set throughout. It was hard. Tears stung in my eyes turning away from Pyreside. The old inn, memories of Mom laughing over the piano at Dad's attempts to play her favourite melody. Of sitting cross-legged by the fire, listening to Nana's fairy tales. All behind me, buried in a blanket of snow.
Thank you.
My first thought was that I'd lost it, cracked like a walnut. I'd heard tales of weary adventurers, sailors and the like falling victim to visions in the night. Faces in the water or shadows of people that weren't really there. But this boy in the snow was real. And he was dying. Everyone told me staying in the mountains would be a mistake. After 3 straight years of winter, even I had to admit it. When frigid winds and frozen storms sent the old bridge crashing down into the valley below, my hopes and spirits went with it. thought I'd been prepared. I was wrong. One step back into the village proper and memories came flooding back.
Thank you. Thank you.